And welcome back. It's about to see us. This is the RPG chick. Why is Aloth right back here? So, welcome back to another episode of the Pillars of Eternity Blind. I don't know what was about to see us or something.
Keeping quiet.
We are in the dungeons in the Great Hall. Going down further still, some prison area. We've just finished investigating a bunch of spiders. Somebody talking to a lieutenant is actually a ghost. Well, that's pretty awesome looking. Never seen that graphic before. Firebrand has gained experience. Endless Pass of Adnua. Endless? Tell me endless. Oh my god. So this is a huge dungeon then. I see. But Firebrand can level up, which is always a good thing. What do you think? She's got 6 points. Athletics. I don't know if individual people need to take mechanics, as long as you have one person who's good at it, right? Don't do that. Fighter abilities. Well, I got the Defender, Confident Aim. Steadies the fighter's arm, causing a percentage of their grazes to be converted to hits and increasing the minimum damage for melee weapons. Oh, nice. Discipline Barrage. The fighter intensely focuses on his or her training, significantly increasing accuracy for a short amount of time. One per encounter. And Guardian Stance. The fighter devotes all his or her energy to defending allies, lowers accuracy but increases the deflection of nearby allies. I like this. I like Confident Aim. We're gonna take Confident Aim. No new talent unlocks. Activated. Awesome. So we got a door here. And we've got... moving on here.
No problem.
We'll take those farmers by surprise. Almost time. Di and Heather scouted the village last night. They're rounding up the rest of the party now.
It's a raider. An elven man turns to face you. His cheeks, his forearms, and the cartilage of his long pointed ears are smeared with indigo and blue paints. He grins wickedly beneath a thatch of wild hair. What party?
Don't worry. Everyone remembers the raid was your idea. The Rio had to go along with it after you'd gotten the rest of the clan riled up. No one wants it said that the Nine Claws were too cowardly to stand with the rest of the tribe when the foreigners desecrated our ruins.
His phantasmal fist sails through your shoulder. The Rio? The ragged stripes of paint on his face twist as he laughs. You may not like them, but they're still our elders. For now. A dead gray tooth peers from between his lips. That was clever, drawing the support of the community first. By the time you approached the Rio, they had no choice but to support us. There's no doubt you'll join their ranks one day. So long as no farmer's pitchfork fells you tonight, he laughs.
The tribes need more leaders like you. Women who value deeds over words.
The ghostly warrior gives you a long, covetous look. His semi-transparent eyes blaze as they crawl over you. He reaches toward your cheek but stops midway, his splayed fingers quivering as a tremor of doubt runs through him.
You were right. We were too soft when the foreigners first came, and now they humiliate us. We'll be soft no more, and the invaders will learn to leave us alone once and for all.
He drops his hand to his side instead, drawing a notched blade from his belt. Interesting.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Okay, so besides that door, I got something over here. We discover this thing, so let's kill it before it discovers us. Or at least damage it a lot, and then we'll kill it. After it hits us once or twice. Of course, we might get a bunch of its friends or family members running over. We'll have to deal with them as well. We get stuck in the doorway, aren't we? Oh, there's a big one. Maybe we can take out the little one. We did, but there's more little ones. Ah. Employing my usual strategies.
Lava.
Who's this? Canna? Hit that thing. Nice. Chop that thing up. Actually, I like it this way. Only one can get through to us at a time. Is she not? Just hit it. I don't think I can get through, actually. So... Divine Mark on the big baddie. With a penalty, as you can't see.
Yes!
Can't get through, he's going insane. Okay.
I shall be discreet.
You do that. So this was kind of chosen for us, so we go in here first. Kind of a big room. What was that? A lizard? A rat? Can't zoom in anymore. Than that. Boots of Stealth, never mind. I was reading the wrong one. Boots are worn for both comfort and style. Most often made of leather, they can be custom made to suit a variety of terrains and purposes. While soldiers and explorers often favor hardy, thick-soled boots, rogues and thieves may prefer soft-soled shoes that allow them to move nimbly and quietly. Yeah, I realize there's no special description for this, but I figured I just finished up talking about it. Who's got the best stealth? Because don't we take... Is it the character with the most stealth? The stealth that we're using? I don't even know. You know what? I'm not even sure, so I'm just going to give it to somebody who doesn't have boots. Which is just about everybody. Where'd these things go? To Aloth. Cobblestones and bricks are bound to the rusted old cart by thick spider webs. Yeah, we get the idea. What is that noise? I kind of don't like that noise. Let's save. Down here. A Zorep. Do you make sounds like that? Because that's pretty silly of you. It's just a regular old Zorep. Oh boy, I've got the rest soon.
Eh?
Oh, maybe that thing is... Oh, there's more than one. There's more than one. That one's really damaged. Ah, out of magic missiles. Wait for them to run up and we'll use arcane assault a couple times. Does he still have to go? Yeah. I want to take care of that one back there. You know what? Here. That's what's making the sound. Look at all these goodies. All Zorp spears, medium shield. Ooh! Heavy iron key. This heavy iron key has an Edirian stamp upon its handle. The handle is coated with a rough layer of rust. Sorry.
Yeah.
I startled him. We really need to rest.
Sure.
For roleplay purposes, just going by the stairs, because that's all he has left, so he'll die for good if we don't rest. And if we don't find camping supplies, we're gonna have to leave and come back. Just suck because it's quite a while as to where anyone's selling them.
Yeah. keeping quiet.
Good idea. I might as well look around in here some more. And then check the other area. Let's kind of ignore that shimmering thing for a sec. Let's see what's in here. Damn, how many freaking spiders? At least we're back at full strength. Everybody? Bet you there's more. At least we got a good head start on that one. This one's gonna die pretty quickly. Let's see if we can take out the ivory one with a magic missile. And, yeah, just a general amplified thrust as usual.
Lava will be on seek.
Good, look at those jibs, man. Wait, is someone hanging back? Who's this? Aider? Firebrand. Kanna? Can you actually run? Is he stuck? He's stuck behind the other two. Do we step over here? And who's us? Theodas? We step over there? Let the guy through? Let's do Defender. I don't know if Knockdown even works on spiders. There are too many damn legs. They die pretty quickly, I don't know. Armor, why not? I was considering just having him hit him with the staff. But, and by moving her, we interrupted that, right? No, I think she did. Oh, she doesn't have enough focus now to even do that. So I guess she did cast it. Theodas, yes. Ooh, crit. Critted it. Awesome. Yeah, I don't always read this stuff, guys. It's a lot of info. I mean, I could sit back and just read it and really analyze it, but then this would get kind of boring for you guys. I'm not good at speed reading, so. So she can do Soul Shock off of Eater as usual. We like to use him as our little puppet guy. These things are still running forward, so. They're gonna run forward more, though. So. Ouchie. Hear those fighters, man. She can wade into battle as well.
What?
To all you guys.
Huh.
Chop them up. Nice. Got here a sword, regular sword. We'll just stick it in there. Let's take a look at our bestiary here. Seeing these flame blights, ivory spinner. Have we seen these before? Enormous and hostile spiders come in a terrifying array of shapes, colors, and sizes throughout the Eastern Reach. You bet. Much more aggressive than their tiny kin, these giants actively seek out human and animal prey. Even the weakest of them, the spear spider, can easily kill a grown kith if the victim is unprepared. Though the spear spider lacks a poisonous bite, its piercing legs, from which its name is derived, can inflict terrible wounds even through armor. Alright, so this is the default explanation, default definition of the spider's bell. Just finish reading it. More deadly than spear spiders are ivory spinners and widowmakers, with both species possessing horrific poisonous bites. The ivory spinner also has the ability to fire webbing at its prey, slowing it down. Ew. Widowmakers do not cast webs, but their poison is extraordinarily toxic. Well, I don't think we've come across them yet. No wonder they call them Widowmakers. Seldom seen outside of the most remote locations in Ir Glanfath, the fabled Crystal Eaters are enormous and powerful, possessing magical abilities some wizards believe to have been developed through the consumption of Adra and enchanted gemstones. In addition to their ability to raise a field of deadly crystal spikes, the venom of a Crystal Eater will temporarily turn a victim's flesh and blood to stone. Subsequent attacks by the Crystal Eater on a petrified foe are quickly fatal. Oof. Is there really nothing actually new? I think by fighting them we've just... Yeah. Oh yeah, since we fought them so many times. We've already defeated 13 of these frickin' things. Now we know all their stats. Uh-huh. We know your stats. So the difference between the spear spider and the spear spiderling. Interesting.
My eyes are peeled.
Sounds extraordinary. Stone beetle. Hello. Crap. And a wood beetle. Huh. So he's got Defender on still. Hmm. Wonder how long that stays active. Well, the stone battle. Stone beetle. Ooh, someone got killed over there. Looks like his head. Yeah! His head got chopped right off. Or that's either his head or his brain. I'm not even sure. Sheesh. Freaking things. Magic missile on the stone beetle. Ooh, knock back the wood beetle. What a hit. Weapon ineffective. Yeah, because you hit something that wasn't there. Oh no, they were in the way? I don't even know. Do that. Soul Shock off of Eater. I say just wait into battle.
Hi.
Not to alarm you.
It burrowed under the ground and went over here. Again with the arcane assault. And since she's out of focus, she'll attack as well. Theodas, that is. All kinds of buggies down here. A beetle shell. The segmented armor-like shell of a very large beetle. You got that right. Golden obols on this corpse. A rare coin even in the Valian Republics, the golden obol double or golden obol? Obol? is a large gold coin. It is mostly used by the extremely wealthy. Nice. It's ours now. Sorry, dude.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Wow, it's a pretty big area. More freaking spiders. Sure, it's not the only one there either. Attack. Maybe we should get the ivory one first. Oh, maybe we should get this one first. Keep finding more and more. Alright. Let the battle begin in earnest. Okay, Vern? There are spiderlings in front, so we'll attack it first. They might not get the benefit of that, but I can always help. Amplified thrust. Either. Maybe we'll finish off that one over there. Now you attack this one, so you don't get an attack of opportunity. These two attack this one. If I did that right. She still has to go. There, necrotic lance on this one. Why not? Armor. Okay, yeah, let's run back. Soul Shock. Hmm. Yeah, just attack this thing.
Hi.
Oh, good. More legs. They got legs. And they know how to use them. Ooh, there's someone wrapped in a cocoon over there.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. Which is not very quiet.
Yeah, you like to talk about that. How do we get there? Oh. Like going around, okay. We obviously have a lot more to explore here. Wow. Having a blast though, guys. Endless paths of Ad Nua. I hope it's not endless. I want to finish this game someday. You see me at 80 years old, yeah. Level 465. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and enduring, grow strong.